Afternoon. Today we are here with another interesting scenario regarding changing another parameter of the Earth, which is called obliquity. Obliquity, as you can see in Wikipedia, this is the angle between an object's rotational axis and its orbital axis. As you can see in the figure, different planets have different obliquities or axial tilts. And for the Earth, for example, this is 23 degrees. For Uranus, this is 98 degrees. So actually, the obliquity is the one of the most important parameters of the Earth, which helps us to have seasons. If we don't have any obliquity and if this angle becomes zero, almost we don't have any season on the Earth. And we can change it this parameter in this universe sandbox. So I'm going to my scenario and try to change the obliquity and see if the season pattern would be changed on the Earth or not. First, I'm opening the overview of the Earth with different parameters. One of these graphs is related to surface temperature. As you can see, close to the poles, we have the minimum temperature of the Earth in the North Pole. I think this is around minus 55, and the South Pole, it's minus around 69, maybe. And the area which are close to the equator line are the most have the most temperature of the Earth. If you can see, for example, in Africa, we have the red area, which is the hottest part of the Earth. So if we change that obliquity or axial tilt, we can see what's going on the Earth. This can be so interesting because I think the creation of the Earth is really interesting. If we change any parameter regarding the current situation, lots of strange things would be happened on the Earth, and maybe it also affects on life likelihood. So I'm going to the motion column, and there is a parameter here which is obliquity, as you can see, and we can change this parameter from here. Let's getting close to the Earth. And I'm decreasing the simulation speed now. So you can see there is a tilt, which is called obliquity. If you see, the Earth is not rotating around itself in a straight way, and it has some tilt with that rotational axis, actually. So with this parameter in the motion, we can change the tilt. For example, I want to increase it with a 90 degrees. So if I add the 90 degrees with this 23, it would be 113. So I'm increasing this obliquity parameter and see what's going on the Earth. I really suggest you to at least try this universe sandbox simulator. It's a great tool which you can experience yourself, whatever you want, whatever you have idea about, and create interesting video or if you are someone who is interested in the astronomy, you can have this experience for yourself. So we have increased the obliquity up to 113. Actually, we have added 90 degrees to the default criteria and amount of obliquity. So you can see the Earth's rotation has been changed, and this is the turning around itself in another angle. It's totally different with the previous type of rotation. and you can see all the continents are like this. This is, I think this is Africa. Yeah, this is Africa, and it's totally different with the view that we have before the change. So I'm waiting for time to be passed and see what's going on the Earth. I'm increasing the simulation speed and see what's going on now. Okay. Oh, you can see the effects here. Actually, the heat pattern of the Earth is totally different with before the change. We had the coldest part of the Earth on the poles, but right now it's not like that. Right now, if you see my pointer, I'm showing you that on the North Pole now we have a high temperature. It's actually getting up to 30 degrees at average temperature, so there wouldn't be any ice anymore in there. Also, if I see the South Pole, it's also the temperature has been increased, and we have some parts on the Earth close to the equator line, which the temperature is not as high as before changing. If I wait, I can see even in some parts I have also, yeah, in here somewhere, like this is the South America, and you can see in the border of this continent we have the lowest temperature. So the pole place somehow has been changed. We don't have the coldest temperature on the South Pole, but we have the coldest part of the Earth close to the equator line, which is usually the hottest part of the Earth in normal situation. Also in Africa, you can see we have lots of minus 40 degrees, minus 10 degrees. So being close to equator line right now, it's not a reason to be in a hot situation. And if you want to go somewhere in the winter, which is hotter than usual, I think you have to move to maybe the poles. The poles are hot. And I'm surfing the map to see what's going on. So Africa, all the average temperatures of Africa right now are on minus 10, minus 20. And what about the North America? Also, North America is minus 20, minus 30. What about the Canada? Canada is one of the coldest part of the Earth, but now it doesn't contain any ice or anything because you cannot see many places which have positive temperature. Lots of the places, I think most places of Canada right now are the hottest part of the Earth, and you cannot see many minus parts in Canada. Also, if you move to this Greenland, which is, as you know, this is the one of the coldest part of the Earth, and now the temperature is variating in different part of this Greenland. So we have minus temperature, we have positive temperatures. What about Iran? What's going on Iran? Oh, Iran also is one of the coldest part of the Earth right now. The average temperature is around 25, minus 25, 26. So you can see actually the results in here in the map. We have lots of freezing parts in Africa now, lots of freezing parts in Iran, and actually we have seasons, but the type of seasons are totally different from the time that we haven't changed the obliquity. So for your scenarios, you can play with this parameter and see what's going on. And there is another parameter also in here, which is related. Let me slow down the simulation. We have something like this argument of obliquity. Also, you can change the type of rotation of the Earth from here. By default, this is 167 degrees. But if I, for example, decrease it up to 79 degrees, you can see with this parameter the type of rotation of the Earth also being changed. For instance, I'm putting it on 65 degrees, and I want to see what would happen in the new situation on the Earth. I'm checking the pattern of the heat, of the temperature of the Earth. So for now, it's actually Africa is one of the coldest part of the Earth. Also South America, which is usually this destination for people in the winter. If everyone is being bothered by the cold weather, they try to move to places close to equator line or Africa or South America. But right now it's different. I think for the winter you have to move to the poles, because it seems the South Pole has the highest temperature, and this is the pattern of freezing on the Earth in the winter. Iran and China and even Saudi Arabia, they are the coldest part of the Earth, and Africa, Egypt, and good places now are, I think it's Europe seems to be hot enough for the winter, which is exactly vice versa with current situation right now. Everyone right now at the winter try to move to the Spain or Italy in Europe, but the situation right now is different. So you can see there are lots of parameters in the Earth which help us to have a normal life as we have right now. And if any parameter of the Earth is being changed, it would affect a lot on our normal life. I'm checking the composition also. The life likelihood is still the same, so we are not losing our population, but I think there would be lots of migration, lots of movement, immigrations on the whole Earth. People try to go to move to the pole. I think the amount of thick is still the same. We have some ices in the poles, but it's different. It's a little bit different with the usual situation. And what about the gas pressure? Is it still the same, so people can live in the Earth, but they have to immigrate to other places, I think. Okay, thanks for watching this video. If you have any suggestion, please write in the comments. If you have any creativity regarding these scenarios, I will read all the comments and try to answer them. And if there is an interesting idea about creating the videos, for sure I will create those videos. And please write in comments if you like this sort of videos. Please support me by subscription of this channel, and have a great day. Thank you very much. Bye.